waterfowl, geese, ducks, whatever it is. There's a group of people out there who dedicate their entire life to the hunt. Well, life savings. The hunt requires countless early mornings, late nights, gallons of gas, but most importantly, the obsession for the hunt. A true hunter's goal is not the pride, it's the hunt, it's the whole process. This series will show you that process. This series will be the greatest series of videos on this channel. This is the Lone Fowler.
Gentlemen, welcome to episode 3 of the Lone Fowler. Fortunately, this is going to be episode 4's hunt. There's supposed to be another episode at this area. We are up at my cabin right now, and I was going to be doing some hunting around here. Been here for about 3 days. Saw zero geese and just some ducks. We went out duck hunting a couple times. Someone was not shooting the greatest. It was pretty chilly out there on the water. I'll show you some of those clips.
Alrighty, guys. Gonna whisper because I just had about 20 to 30 woodies land about 80 yards in the reeds over to my right. I still got about 5-10 minutes of shooting light. Dude, you're terrible, Brogan. Jesus Christ. Oh my gosh.
Ladies and gentlemen, as you can see, I am all bundled up. It's 35 degrees out and there's 15 mile an hour winds. We're gonna go sit out where we sat yesterday morning. There's just not a lot of ducks around. We've been scouting a lot and there's just no places that we can find. So we're on this big lake here that some of these ducks roost on, and then once the sun rises, they get up and they start flying around and they move around. So hopefully we can get some shooting in. We got about 45 minutes of shooting time. Should probably get out there.
on, Mallard.
All right, ladies and gentlemen. Just got back from a little cold morning hunt. I don't know if you guys could really tell there. It started snowing this morning. It was really cold, 34 degrees, 35 degrees. Super cloudy, like sun like didn't really show up until right about 8 o'clock, 8:15. But a lot of ducks were migrating. It seemed like a lot of ducks were flying really high. I saw some big groups. And then we had just a couple groups around us. Pretty tough. None of them were really decoying. Should have had that mallard. There was another mallard that came in. I thought the bigger group was going to work, and then he came in. He was floating right above me. Tough shot. And then GoPro actually died when I was picking up decoys. But when I was picking up decoys, I had a group of about 20 of these guys come in. So I decided to give her the beans, and I just lined a couple up. Ended up dropping two of them. So we're going to do a little comparison here. We're going to take some cook some coot up. And then we got the wood duck that we shot. So we're going to cook these guys up. And
all right, ladies and gentlemen. We got these ducks cleaned up. Here's the wood duck and then the two coot. See a little just the meat comparison there. Had to clean up the coot a little bit. Coot are a little more fatty. But yeah, we're going to get these guys cleaned up. And fried up, gonna make them with some eggs, chunk them up. I don't really know what the plan. I might do little strips. Just kind of cut them in some nice thin strips, and see how they taste.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, got the meat cooked up here. Hold on, let me get a fork. Alrighty, I think I'm gonna just go with the wood duck first. Good. Only seasonings I threw on it. Some of this complete seasoning. A little bit of garlic salt. And a little bit of black pepper. That's it. Just try to keep it as simple as possible. That wood duck was fine. Tasted good. Nice and tender. Now for the coot. I don't know if I got these mixed up, but I swear to God that coot tasted better. The coot tasted the exact same to me as that wood duck. Just saying. Just saying for all you coot haters out there. Just saying. Now we're heading up north, going up a little farther north towards North Dakota. We might be going to North Dakota tonight, unless we can find something to hunt along the way. I'm gonna be scouting the entire way, and if I find something that looks pretty juicy, well then we're sleeping in the back here, and we're gonna camp that place out and hunt it in the morning, and then we'll head to North Dakota. So yeah, we got about an hour and a half of driving to do, and then fingers crossed we can find some birds. We got some north winds coming in. It's getting chilly. It's snowing this morning. Birds should be moving. Let's go. Let's go find them. Well, ladies and gents, this is the first or second spot technically that I've came and scouted up in this new area. Wow, it's crazy. You drive an hour north and all of a sudden there is birds. There is a lot of ducks out here. You can't even see them. They're all tucked to this shoreline, so you can't really get over the I can't really see them, but there's a lot of ducks here. And yeah, as of now, this is where we're gonna hunt tomorrow morning. I'm gonna go see if we can find some better spots though.
Morning, ladies and gentlemen. 6:18.
As you maybe can tell, we roughed it out in the truck last night, or in the van. But it's, it was 31 degrees when I went to bed, and it's 34 degrees right now. Oh, lovely. It says flurries starting in 41 minutes. That's perfect. Time to get set up, head out there, and shoot some birds. Let's go.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we just got set up here. It's got a, we got about a 12 mile an hour north wind right now, north northwest, but eventually through the day it's going to turn more to west, which will be good because it'll put me at, or put the wind at my back. I got a group out here on the right just to keep them from landing, obviously way over there. I want them more to land right in here. So I got a group of mallards kind of stretch right there, and then I got some puddle ducks here close to me. Then I got another little group of mallards right there. I saw a couple ducks flying so far. They've been quacking nonstop. I'm guessing some of them roosted on that other side there. I can actually see there's a ton of coot. You know, when I was scouting this yesterday, I took a little closer step, and with the binos, and I realized about 50 to 60% of these birds were coot. But there were still a lot of nice mallards and some other ducks in here too, so fingers crossed we can get those guys up and moving and close enough to take some shots at. But yeah, I can actually just see them lined up along the shore over there. So I guess good thing I didn't try to set up over there, because I would have spooked every single one of them, I'm guessing. There was a lot of ducks sitting on this shoreline too. Who knows when they'll get here. We'll just have to sit, play the waiting game. It's snowing right now, actually. So, yeah. Hopefully the birds start moving once the sun gets up. Obviously, you picked the wrong spot.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is going to be it for episode 3 of the Lone Fowler. Yeah, that was an absolute struggle. We struggled to find birds, we struggled to kill birds. It was just a struggle all around. Got cold, it was freezing, snowing, sleeting. It was pretty tough out there. And we ended up, only shooting one duck and two coot. And I know, sorry, I didn't get those on video. But, yeah, that's going to be it for this video. Make sure you guys watch to the end here. Don't get out of this video after this clip. Watch the end. We got a little sneak peek of episode 4 and 5. A little sneak peek, and it's going to be good. We make it to North Dakota. Things start to come together. Enjoy. Story, something to get off my chest. My life is kinda boring. Need something that I can confess. And I always find, yeah, always find something wrong. You've been putting up with my shit just way too long. Swear, thought you saw me wink, no. I've been on the brink, so tell me what you want to hear.